why I pay up, I put pens in first and bring the cost, because it's replicating what you do in the wild.
Oh, that's interesting.
But they don't do that, and what the natural instinct is the hens to go and find the nest boxes. Yeah. I'm not saying it's right or well. Yeah. I think
a lot of people put going in, don't they?
Yeah. But if there was in the Australia, can't take the natural instincts out of them. Mm. That's why I put hens in first. I've never put cocks in first because they're already successful. When I put cocks, I put hens in a pen, they always breed. When we were beginners, half the pairs, when they were good, they wouldn't pair up. It's because we didn't know what we were doing. It's just experience. And people say to me, how do you know when the hens fit? It's a good thing, isn't it? You can just, experience tells you when they start, the hen just starts to wiggle a bit, don't they? And their beak goes, and they look at the nest box. In the aviary, before I pair up, I put some nest boxes in. I just sit on the stool watching for half an hour. And if I have 100 hens in there, I can see that 20 of them are ready to breed. Yeah. Because they have that experience again.
Looking at them.
And also, this is a crazy thing I'm going to say now, but I can go into my aviary, and if there's something wrong, I can sense it. I can't explain it, but if there's a hen died, in the box, the chicks or die somewhere. I can walk in and think there's something wrong here. The noise isn't quite right. And I've got this feeling of the birds, and I go, I can go up along and go to the nest box and open, that's where the problem is. And I've got 39 nest boxes. But I can go to it and find the problem. I can't explain it. People say, how do you know? I said, I can go in, I can smell problems as well. Sickness, I can smell. The bird is throwing up. I can smell it. I've got a great sense of smell. Another thing, when you see a bird, if you ever bind a bird, smell its nostrils and smell its ass. Bottom, I mean, not ass. Yeah. And if you ever bind a bird, hold it. Because, you know, a bird can hide a lot of things.
Yeah, the feather.
Yeah. And the most important is the breast feather. Yeah. So, any luck? Come on. What's in the girl? Where we go at?
French mole. What'd you do? Did you get it?
Yes and no. Well, French mole. Over the years, a bear comes out of the box and sews its wife's and tail. I don't think that's French mole. That's stress. A French mole is when they go like a plump chicken, that's when you can tell the difference. I get the biggest problem I have, chicks coming out. I've had a few this year. I've never been overrun by it, I've always had a few. I put it down to my problem, not the bear's problem. Usually too many chicks in the box. There's a nest of four or five. They come out, they don't feed, the parents will feed them. Stressful to lose a flight and tails. But they always run back. That's stress. French mold, it's a virus. Am I an expert on it? No. I will, if they're really bad, they go to Jesus. I hate doing that.
Do you stop breathing now? Do you breathe through French mold?
I've never had it that bad, so I don't. I know a friend of mine, he always has it. I always say to stop breathing when he continues to breathe. So that's the one. I would think if you're getting bad, you should be stop breathing now. They're getting tired. Also, with the bears of today, I think three chicks is the maximum they can bring up successfully. That's a really good, now I'm talking about top exhibition birds. No, the top birds. If you have five or six in, though they eight eggs, you get a few actually more off feeding them. But the problem is now getting full, big full nests. We used to get huge full nests, but now we don't.